So, with the MacBook Pro line now updated, our attention is now towards the MacBook Air. We've had a report of the new design revealed for the MacBook Air. I want to discuss all the details on this and also I want to give you the latest on the new MacBook Air release date and price and of course a summary on design and specs as well. Hi, it's Matt here. So new MacBook Pros are here. But what about Macs that will get the new M2 chipset inside and what will they be capable of? Well, it's been over 10 months since we had an update to the MacBook Air. The biggest change we saw in that last model was the new Apple Silicon M1 chipset put inside and also the cooling fan being removed from the model. But with leaks and rumours dropping in for the new MacBook Air, I have decided for all the new MacBook videos like this one going forward, I'm going to give you the latest details on specific models, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the MacBook starting prices and features that we have learnt in previous leaks. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the next MacBook Air. Also, put in the comments below of what features you'd like to see in the next MacBook Air, and in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. Let's start then with the news of the new design MacBook Air. So, John Prosser, a leaker who has been a modest source of information on leaks, has been correct more in 2021 than not, but has shared some more news that the new MacBook Air will take a lot of design elements from the new MacBook Pro. The design shared can be seen in these photos made with renders by Ian, and quite a few of these renders in these videos that you can see right now also share the similar design. They include a white bezel like the 24-inch iMac, but then other changes include the same design notch that we've just got on the 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro, but of course it's in white. Other notable changes is that the keyboard is fully white like the 24-inch iMac, but the actual keyboard layout is very similar again to the new MacBook Pro design. But again, like I keep saying, it will all be in white and we will also get that new Touch ID button. The last two changes that can be seen is that the MagSafe 3 is returning back to the MacBook Air, and also for the USB-C ports layout, one will now be on the left side and one will be on the right side with a headphone port. Right now with the MacBook Air, the two USB-C ports are all on one side. So, like a few of my other videos, just a quick note here. With any of these leaks, even up to the new MacBook Air's release date that I find and show you guys, a lot of previous leaks for other Apple products have come true, but there are sometimes some that get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I have been told and shown. No leak or rumour is 100% true until we see the final MacBook Air being officially shown from Apple. However, if you are like me and if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation MacBook Air is going to be like and want to know what the latest leaks and rumours are, no matter what they tell us. So with that out of the way, let's talk about the release date next and then a summary of everything we know with the prices included as well. So then guys, just quickly, this channel got over 260,000 subscribers and I announced who the winner was for this brand new iPad Pro M1. And do check out my video on my channel of who this iPad Pro is going to. But the great news is guys, I am doing another giveaway and it is for this. It is for a brand new iPhone 13 Pro Max 128GB model in the Sierra Blue. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And just like the last giveaway, what I want you guys to do is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in 2021 or maybe into 2022. Also at the same time, make sure you subscribe to this button, hit that notification bell, because when we get over 300,000 subscribers, I will be notifying you guys of who the winner is of this brand new iPhone. And just quickly on that, I do want to quickly comment that if you do get a comment to say that you've won or something like this before we hit the 300,000 marker, it is probably not me. It is most likely a scammer. And the best way you can tell if this is a scammer or not is basically open up that person's account by clicking on their profile and you'll be able to see how many subscribers they got. And if they've got less than 260,000 subscribers, like at the time I'm making this video here, then basically you will know they are not me. Plus, also at the same time as well, they will probably have hardly any videos uploaded, and also their account will probably be very, very new. So do ignore these emails or these messages from these people, or what you can do is at the same time, you can actually report them to YouTube. But enough of that, like I said, over 300,000 subscribers is the only time I'm going to be announcing who the winner is of this iPhone 13 Pro Max, and that's the only prize I'm going to be doing between now and then. So make sure you subscribe to this channel, hit that notification bell. Also at the same time, guys, if you're liking this video so far, please do press the like button. Well, let's get back to the main video. So release day, I'm going to make a more dedicated video on the leaks we have heard about it. However, in short, originally we thought until WWDC this year, we could be getting the M2 MacBook Air in 2021, in October or November time. But with these leaks and rumours from Mark Gurman, Ming-Chi Kuo, you can see here with the mini LED, you can see everything is more pointing towards a 2022 release instead. A few other leakers have pointed at early 2022 as well, and we've also got to remember we've just had the new MacBook Pros, the 14-inch and the 16-inch release with that M1 Pro and M1 Max inside it, and it's likely that Apple will not be launching any more new MacBooks in 2021. So I believe based on these facts, it is likely that the early 2022 date is on the cards for a release with the new MacBook Air. So going forward, I'm going to be saying 2022 as the release date. But when in 2022, you might ask? Well, as some of the leaks have said in this video, it's going to be early 2022. If Apple's track records of events and announcements is anything to base time on, based on these leaks, I do believe we'll get a 2022 release, but if that release will be in March, April time or the end of the year, I'm not too sure at this time. But I'm sure more leaks and rumours will come out between now and then. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the 2022 MacBook Air is going to give us and also the prices. So what we've heard for the MacBook Air M2 or the new model that's coming out in 2022, it will be a 13.3 XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. Now it's likely this 13.3 inch display is going to be retained and not upgraded to a 14 inch just yet. The main reason is, even with the new MacBook Pro 14 inch coming out, it is likely Apple are going to still continue to sell the MacBook Pro M1, what has a 13.3 inch display as well, so I'm sure the MacBook Air will also be retaining its same size screen. But the resolution of that screen will be the same of what we get on the MacBook Air right now, what will be a 1680 by a 1050, and it will also be a ProMotion display for the first time, what will be a 120Hz refresh rate built into that display. So very similar to the 12.9-inch iPad Pro that we have right now. For storage, it is likely it's going to be very similar to what we have right now. So 256GB, 512, 1TB and 2TB storage options. There will be that brand new M2 chipset inside it, and it is likely, according to the latest leaks, what I will cover more in other videos, to be an 8-core CPU and also a 10-core GPU at the moment. There will also be the option again of 8GB or 16GB of RAM to pick for your MacBook Air. The actual design is going to be a completely new design, as you can see here. It's likely it's going to be a little bit more thinner than the MacBook Air we have right now, but we're also going to be getting colours as a first, according to some of the latest leaks and rumours. But it will be made out of aluminium, and there will still be two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on one side, and also those Thunderbolt 4 ports will be also compatible with USB 4. The new design, what I just spoke about, the new colours ranges that are coming out for it will be blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange and purple, what are the exact same colours that we got with the iMac M1. It's also likely we've been told that there's going to be a centre stage webcam in the middle of the new MacBook Air, what will be a 12 megapixel camera. Battery life is going to be the same what we're getting right now, so up to 18 hours if you use it well. And then prices wise, it looks likely that it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, with 256GB starting at $999, 512GB at $1,249, 1TB at $1,499, and 2TB at $1,849. Now, obviously, all these specs that I've just shown you here are based on what we know at the moment. This could change in the future. But next, for my wishes for the MacBook Air. My wish is to do with the colours. So we've seen some great colours in the concepts and renders that you're looking at right here. But also, there are some rumours and leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is going to have all these multiple different colours that are going to be very similar to the iMac and the iPad Air, for example. However, I would like to still have the ability to buy a silver, a gold, or a space grey MacBook Air like we can right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with having this kind of choice or not. Also, at the same time, write in the comments what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Air in 2022. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon. Bye.